In today's video is going to be really cool. I'm going to show you how you can eliminate micro scratches and fingerprints with your infotainment screen as well as your digital gauge cluster for your Range Rover Discovery or even the new Defender. Hey everybody, my name's Emeka, and this is my 2019 Driven Hard Range Rover Sport. Now, if you're like me, micro scratches drive you absolutely crazy. I hate seeing the scratches on my infotainment screens as well as fingerprints from just touching everything, but it's just a fact of life. When you have a whole bunch of screens in your vehicle, things are gonna get marked up. However, I have found a way to eliminate those, and I'm gonna be showing you exactly what I'm talking about in today's video. So the product that I found is called Screen Protect. And what this is, it's a thin film that you place over your lower panel screen, your main screen, I guess, as well as your digital gauge cluster. And what this does is it won't remove the actual scratches, but with the film applied, you won't be able to see the original scratches anymore, and you won't be able to add any new scratches as well. And it does help reduce considerably the amount of fingerprints that you're gonna have all over your screens. So this is one of the best ways that I found that helps your car looking new day in and day out, even better than the day you picked it up from the dealership. So Screen Protect, they make protection for all Range Rover models from 2013 and up, Discovery from 2017 and up, I believe, as well as protection on the new Defender. Now, if you guys like the results of this, I'm going to have all of Screen Protect's info down in the description, as well as the links where you can find screens for your specific Land Rover product or other vehicle, as they make a ton of different configurations or whatever on their website. So let's see what's in the packet. All right, so let's see what comes in the tube here. So you get your solution. So you get one bottle of the solution. And then these are the actual cutouts that we're gonna be putting onto the screen here. And what's really cool is they have, I think they call it like an insurance, and it's only a few bucks to actually double. So I actually have two templates for each one in case I do a mistake or whatever the case is. So that's kind of a neat thing that they do. Then we have our little rubber applicator helper to help squeegee out all of the solution. And then of course a microfiber cloth to clean and prep the surface. And then lastly, your install guide. In case this video just doesn't cut it, you can go to the pros as well. So I'm gonna install this the very first time. So I haven't, there's nothing on it right now. So you guys are gonna see me do it the first time. So it'll be a good indicator of how easy this installation is. And if you're like me, I only deal with easy products. I don't have the time to complicate and mess things up and nope. So let's get to it. Okay, so I have the solution here, guys. And what it is, you just basically add some water to this, shake it up like so. And first I'm going to spray the screen and then take the microfiber towel that they provide. And this was already pretty clean, but because remember, whenever you're doing something like this, the cleaner the surface, the better the install. And what's a cool thing about this is it's not a permanent thing. So if you screw it up, or if you just don't like it, you can always just remove it and you're back to your scratched screen. So I'm going to take my template and just peel this off. Okay. Now I'm going to spritz. And then, and here goes nothing. Remember, I'm a complete amateur at this. I've never done this before. I'm a little nervous, but I really wanted to give you the firsthand experience to see how easy it is or not Getting it around the knobs. Okay, I could have put a bit more solution, I think, just to make it easier to fit. Okay, there we go. A couple extra sprays. All right, so now it's just removing all the air bubbles. And like I said, those of you who have done stuff like this before, you might be like, "How? What's he doing?" But hey, this is my first time doing this. But I think it's actually a little easier than I thought it was going to be, which is good. Oh man, this is already looking so much better. Oh wow, this is cool. All right, so just removing all of the air pockets. And what I'll do is I'll actually get my phone. Okay, so that could be a little tighter, I think, around here. This works really well to get in like the little crevice. Oh my gosh, that's so much better. So how's the fit? Fit is bang on. Fit is bang on. Not bad for my first job. That's great. So just needs to be cleaned up. Now, I think, I don't know if you can see, but they give you even the little knobs for inside here. So what I'll do is, same thing, little spritz, probably a little too much. And I'm just gonna place that over there. Now, how am I gonna get that? I think that'll just dry. But, like I said, if you mess it up, you can always just redo it. If you got the second one, it just goes on like that. And then I'm not even gonna bother doing that one because that one's good to go still. Oh, that's so cool. Now I'll clean this up a little bit more once it's dried and everything. But oh, I am super happy with this so far. So let's go ahead and let's do the upper screen now. So to do the upper screen, quick little spritz. There are zero scratches on that screen. Zero, especially compared to the other one. But we're gonna do it anyways because I would like to use this as a preventative measure, and fingerprints on that top screen are a pain in the butt. Yeah, easy. Remove those air pockets. Okay, perfect. That helped quite a bit. Like I said, I've never really done these type of installs before, so those of you who have done PPF or stuff like that yourselves probably laughing at this, but yeah. At least it's nice and forgiving. Oh yeah, no, it's much better. There we go. Nice. All right. All right, guys, I am super happy with the results of this screen protect. And to be completely transparent, I did decide to take it off of the front console. Just like I said, it's in mint condition and the fingerprints aren't an issue because I'm not there touching anything. There's nothing to touch. So I just didn't want to bother with it. So I didn't do that one, but the other two, I am just thrilled with how it's turned out. So this is really, really cool. Like I said, the install process was a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be. And yeah, overall, I'm just really impressed with the product. So the links are gonna be down in the description of this video, and they have a lot of different vehicles that you can get a kit for. So this could be a great gift idea for anybody who's, you know, just likes to keep their stuff looking good and protected from fingerprints and everything. But what do you guys think? What do you think of this product? And is this something you definitely need to pick up for yourself? So, and then the one last thing I wanna do is, how does it affect the performance of the of the screens and everything? So let's take a look at that. And I'm not sure how much the camera if the camera's gonna be able to pick up anything. But finally. All right. No, man, it all works. It's all good. Look at that. Right? Don't you love that first morning startup? God, I'm probably going to get roasted in the comments for that one. But everybody, I'm a Mac, and this is Driven Hard. Thanks to Screen Protect. This was not a sponsored video. I went and purchased the kit myself, but you know, hey, hook a brother up and use those links down in the description if you're gonna pick up a kit for yourselves. I appreciate it. Till next time, everyone, let me know in the comments, what are you driving hard?